Hello, my plant friends. My name is Becca. Thank you so much for clicking on this video. Today, I'm going to be sharing with you the official update on my Enjoy Pothos overhaul project. And I've actually been putting off filming this video because I got a few comments saying that what I did was wrong or not the best thing I could have done and I should have done it in XYZ way, you know, all of these other solutions. If you were one of those people, I really appreciate your feedback, and this is not at all like me commenting on the haters or, oh, that's really gross, but yeah, that's not at all what this video is. But I just wanted to share what I have notes down here so that I don't like, because I'm nervous to talk about this, so I just wrote down what I wanted to say. It is kind of like admitting a fail, and doing that on the internet is not fun. Publicly failing kind of sucks. And so now that I've made you think that I killed the plant, I just want you to know I didn't. There's still a lot of pieces that survive, and I'm just gonna take you back through what happened after I filmed that video and separated the plant and stuff. There's still probably about half of the original plant left over, some still in the original pot, and others I removed from the pot and just put in water. If you missed the video where I found this pothos, I will do a Spark Notes version of it. So basically, I found this Enjoy Pothos that was huge, like I'll insert a picture. It was gigantic, and I found it at a local nursery and I was really, really stoked about it, but it was in seemingly good condition. And I say seemingly because it was actually in terrible condition and I was really, really sad to find this out. I lifted the hood, so broke open the pot basically because the plant would not come out on its own. And I found that the roots were in horrible condition. They were rotted, pot bound, root bound, mushy, smelly, need I go on? I don't think that I really portrayed that very well in the video because I was kind of like, it's root bound. But like the roots on the inner section of the plant were just disgusting, and that was a majority of the plant. I basically had to throw out the entire root system and start the entire plant as fresh cuttings. And there were some pieces that had salvageable roots, and I did keep those, but it was on very, very small amount of the plant. Okay, so flash forward to a week after that video was filmed. So the first couple of weeks were a little bit tough because being a beginner, a learner of this whole plant thing, I put them under my grow light because I was like, grow light, plants, perfect. And I didn't realize that they were so sensitive in that moment, and a lot of the leaves actually ended up burning and dying. Once I removed them from the grow light area, the plants started to kind of turn around. They started getting a little bit better, but they were in a very, very severe shock. Most plants, when you repot them or separate them or do anything like this, they are going to go through shock, and this shock was just really extreme. I'm gonna sneeze. Oh, allergy season is real. They have since perked up. What was left of the plants has perked up. I lost, like I said, about half of it, but I still have half of it. So this is definitely a glass is half full situation for me. I'm gonna sneeze again. My face is making weird faces because I wanna sneeze. Okay, so I will show you what remained in the nursery pots, or sorry, the original pots. So I started all of these plants as fresh propagation cuts in soil, which I'm not very experienced with, which might be the reason that a lot of them did not do well. But this is one of them, and it has pretty much kept its fullness. It's lost a few pieces, but as you can see, if you can, there's new leaves coming in, like right here, and a few other spots there's new leaves, and there have been quite a few new growth pieces on this plant. So that's really exciting. This was one of the plants that was under the grow light, so it lost, you know, a couple of strands, but it's doing a lot better now. This is another one that was under the grow light. It lost quite a bit of fullness, but there is still so much plant here, and I think that I see some new leaves. This one is probably in the worst condition out of them all. But yeah, so this one still hanging in there. And then I have these pieces here that I actually removed from soil and put in these jars, which are doing really awesome. This one is actually putting out new leaves in a few different places. And so basically I realized that if I had started the plant in water to begin with, I would have probably, I don't know, I would have probably been able to save like 70% of the plant rather than 50% of the plant. But I just know that like with the situation, I was gonna lose a lot of the plant no matter what. As you can see here, this is an entirely new root system that has grown in. And so it's almost ready to be potted. Oh gosh, I just dropped water on myself. It's almost ready to be potted up. So I have these two and I'll probably pot them together. I almost forgot I have like a big vase of it. One second. Okay. This was one of the plants that was in a pot about this size, and I ended up removing it because it was drooping really, really bad, and then I ended up putting it in water actually really early on, and it has kept almost all of the pieces. So this one is doing probably the best, and it's been in the water the longest. So it has a really established root system in there, and so I could probably pot this one up like today. My camera died, which is so classic me, but I am almost ready to pot this one up, and I definitely will be doing that soon, just not right now because I just don't want to. But anyway, so I just wanted to come on and share with you that it hasn't been a complete fail. And to anyone who offered me advice and constructive criticism, I'm so thankful for you. Thank you so much for helping me out with this plant undertaking. And I'm happy to say that it's doing well. And whatever is left of the plant is so happy, which makes me happy. And yeah, I guess that might be all. Let's see. I have my notes. Like I said, I was nervous to film this. Oh. Okay, here's what I wanted to say. So for my next video or a video coming up in the next couple of weeks, I was thinking about filming a Q&A. So if you have any questions about my plants, me, my life, anything, you can leave them down in the comments below and I will compile them for a video and see if there's enough to even make a video. If there's not, then I'll just answer them in the comments. But if there is, then I will save them for a video. And so yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. I super, super duper appreciate it. If you like what I've got going on here, make sure that you subscribe to my channel, like this video, maybe share it with a plant friend, and don't forget to tag your city, hashtag. Remember, tag your city plus indoor jungle on Instagram for a feature in my highlight bubbles. All right, see you guys later, bye.